It's good to know that when you purchase Premier, even if you just purchase Premier by itself, you actually get a load of several other applications that are very helpful as well. One of those we've already talked about is Adobe Bridge, which is a great file browsing application. And as we talked about, it's a great file importer as well. As you see a clip that you like, just double click it. If you've launched Bridge from Premiere, all you have to do is double click it and you will import files. To launch Bridge from Premiere, just go to File and then Browse in Bridge. Another very interesting application that comes with Premiere is Adobe On Location. This is a capture program. So if you hook up your camera to your computer, let's say you have a laptop in the field, you can actually record directly to disk from On Location. It's almost like capturing footage with tape, except instead of capturing to tape, you're recording directly to the computer. So you don't have to worry about expensive media and that type of thing for your camera. Here in On Location, you could also create a shot list, and you could create a shot placeholder, and you could make your shot list here. And then as you shoot in the field, you could link up what you've shot with these empty placeholders to make sure you don't miss anything. It's here in On Location that you could also add metadata to the clips that you've recorded so that as you bring them into Premiere from On Location, that you can automatically search for certain lines of dialogue and that type of thing. There's a few camera calibration tools, such as the waveform and the vector scope here, which allow you to look at what your camera is looking at, not through the viewfinder, but through a really intelligent analysis of what's going on there so you can make the necessary changes. There's, of course, one of my favorite applications. It's Adobe Encore. Adobe Encore is a very high-end DVD and Blu-ray authoring application. It actually creates flash video websites, which are pretty cool too, from the same projects. So I love Encore. I do a lot of the Encore training on lynda.com. So feel free to check out that application. It's very easy to use. If you've used Premiere and you feel even slightly comfortable with Premiere, Encore will be a breeze. And before you know it, you'll be making very complex DVD projects with the drop of a button. It comes with this huge library with several sets of different types of project, already made DVD menus and buttons and shapes and all kinds of cool things. So Premiere isn't just Premiere. Premiere is this huge suite of applications, even if you just buy Premiere by itself without Production Premium or the Adobe Master Collection. Now, one other application I want to tell you about that's not really an application technically, it's called Adobe Story. If you are in the video world, Video Story might be a real benefit to you. It's a new developing technology. It's free. It's online. And you can find it here at labs.adobe.com/technologies/story. Basically, it's made for screenwriters. It's made for the pre-production phase of creating a video. And the intelligence behind this is that you will create your script in Adobe Story. And then you will take your Adobe Story text, the script that you've created in Adobe Story, you will be able to take that into On Location. And then when you are in On Location, you could link up the clips with the script from Adobe Story. And then that script that you've written, the dialogue, that will stay attached to those clips throughout the editing process. And you could reference that throughout On Location, throughout Premiere, throughout Encore, throughout After Effects. And so Adobe is really trying to create a very kind of futuristic workflow where everything is connected. And if you want to find character or a prop or anything, you could just do a search and all that data will be in the clips. It will be embedded in the metadata of the clips. And that starts here in Adobe Story. So while that does not necessarily come with Premiere, everybody has access to Adobe Story. And it's, as for right now, it's free. I've seen this work and it's pretty intelligent. It goes through your script and it can actually recognize different characters by the formatting, based on screenplay formatting, recognizes characters, locations, and that type of thing, and could organize stuff and get you ready to create a shot list and that type of stuff. So it's a really great little application, especially with that free price tag. So anyways, just a little brief introduction here to the other applications that come with Premiere.